Pumping wells, other words are withdrawal wells, discharge wells, or abstraction wells, are functional for the withdrawal of groundwater from aquifers for use as drinking water or for use in agriculture and industry. Because it takes a long time to replenish groundwater, authorities and drinking water companies should take care not to deplete all water stored underground in an aquifer. To counter depletion, water can be infiltrated from infiltration canals or recharge wells. Other words are infiltration wells or injection wells. We will start off with a standalone well, a well within an area with no regional groundwater flow. This picture shows a planned view of steady groundwater flow to a pumping well in the center of a homogeneous isotropic confined aquifer. Groundwater flow, in blue, is perpendicular to parallel cylinders with a constant depth D, the aquifer thickness. The volume flux or discharge from the well, Q0 in cubic meter per day, is constant. Because the groundwater flow is steady, the volume flux perpendicular to the area of the parallel cylinders is constant. As these cylinders, the circles in this plan view, become smaller in the direction of the pumping well, in order for the volume flux to remain constant, the volume flux density must increase towards the pumping well. Thus, the aquifer is homogeneous. Also, the hydraulic gradient increases towards the pumping well. This figure shows radial symmetric steady groundwater flow to a fully penetrating pumping well in a confined aquifer in cross-section view. A fully penetrating well is a well that is incised to the top of the below impermeable layer. Please acknowledge that this cross-section view rotates around the center of the aquifer. Lowercase or small r is the radius from the well. The center of the aquifer is thus at small r equals 0. Model-wise, this figure shows radial symmetric flow to a well in the center of a circular island with a fixed boundary condition h equals h large r being the radius of the island from the center of the island or well. In reality, h large r is the hydraulic head at the location where the pumping well ceases to be of influence. Or, in other words, the pre-pumping hydraulic head in the aquifer that has no regional groundwater flow. Confined aquifers may contain very large volumes of water, as water is stored under pressure in the pore space of the aquifer. The volume flux or discharge Q0 from such a well in a confined aquifer equals small qr times 2 pi r times D. Q0 is the volume flux or discharge at small r equals 0 from the well in cubic meters per day. Small qr is the radial symmetric volume flux density in meter per day. 2 pi r is the circumference of a circle in meter, and 2 pi r times D is the cylindrical area perpendicular to the radial symmetric groundwater flow in square meters. In the earlier discussed steady groundwater flow cases, the hydraulic head H decreases with increasing positive X in the direction of flow, linking a positive volume flux with a negative hydraulic gradient, and vice versa. Because of this, a minus sign is present in Darcy's law. However, in this radial symmetric steady groundwater flow case, the hydraulic head H decreases with decreasing, thus not increasing but decreasing, small r in the direction of flow. As water is pumped up, thus flowing upward in a pumping well, that is, in a positive z direction, it is preferred to assign a positive sign to this volume flux or discharge Q0 at the center of the pumping well. Because then both Q0 and the hydraulic gradient are positive in the direction of flow, the minus sign must be dropped in this radial symmetric version of Darcy's law. In Darcy's law describing the volume flux density small qr, the minus sign should be dropped. Thus, Darcy's law then is as stated here to the left. Qr is the radial symmetric volume flux density in meter per day. K is the saturated hydraulic conductivity in meter per day. dHdr is the hydraulic gradient in the direction of the pumping well. Combining the equation in the center, the continuity equation for this radial groundwater flow case, with Darcy's law, delivers the following potentiometric drawdown surface as a function of the radial distance from the pumping well, small r. H is the hydraulic head at a distance small r from the well in meter. HR is the pre-pumping hydraulic head in meter. Q0 is the volume flux or discharge from the well at R equals 0 in cubic meter per day. KD is the aquifer's transmissivity in square meter per day. Small r is the distance from the well in meter. And large r is the radius of influence of the pumped well in meter. Ln is the natural log function, log to the base e. This equation is known as the Dupuit equation. The equation holds from the outside, or radius of the pumping well, to the radius of influence of the pumped well, large r. The volume flux or discharge Q0 from a pumping well is positive, whereas the volume flux or discharge Q0 for a recharge or injection well should be taken as negative. This slide shows the derivation of the Dupuit equation. Here we have the Darcy equation. Here we have the continuity equation. We insert the Darcy equation into the continuity equation. This is what we get. We rewrite it in this shape. And then we integrate it, as shown here, which gives this answer. Then we insert the boundary condition, and this is new. We insert the boundary condition small r equals large r to find out c, and then this is the equation we get. Using this Dupuit equation, the lowering of the hydraulic head, hr minus h for a pumping well, can be determined for every radial position r between R equals RW, which is the outside of your pumping well, and R equals large R. It is clear that for a pumping well, the drawdown, defined as H minus HR, H being smaller than H large R, has a negative value. Instead of integrating this equation without bounds, which delivers the Dupuit equation as we just saw, we could also have integrated between the bounds h1 and h2 at the radiuses r1 and r2 from the center of the well. This delivers this equation, which can be rewritten as this equation, which is known as the Thiem equation.